Hey Girl Scouts, my name's Ruth Lonvick and I'm the STEM Support Manager with the Girl Scouts of Greater Atlanta. I'm in Georgia, which is in the southern United States. Today we are going to investigate the moon. You've probably looked at the moon at night a lot of times, right? It's very big, super bright, up in the sky. But have you ever seen it out during the day? Why do you think that happens? It's pretty crazy, right? But we can see the moon in our sky for about 12 hours of our 24-hour day. I looked online, and today in Atlanta, we should be able to see the moon from 4 a.m. to about 4 p.m. Unfortunately, it's pretty cloudy today. We're not going to have very good luck seeing it. But you can check online and see when you can see the moon in your part of the country, and I would invite you to go outside and check it out. So let's take a closer look at the moon. Let's look up at the sky, maybe use some binoculars if you have them, or look at a picture online. There are lots of lighter spots, lots of darker spots. What do you think those darker spots are? I know that they're craters. There's things that have slammed into the moon and made a big impact. So today we're going to do a really neat art project to explore the different features of the moon. And we're going to earn part of the Brownies Space Science Explorer badge. By the end of this video, you'll learn how to investigate and you're going to learn a lot more about the moon. Now let's get started. This activity will take about 30 minutes to complete with 5 minutes of prep and about 5 minutes of cleanup. You're going to need the moon resource sheet to learn more about the moon. You can also look online for this information. Ask a parent to help you out. You're going to want some paint, some paper, and lots of different craft supplies. Think about things that might look like the moon, things that you might see in space. What do you think you want to use? You can use small objects, buttons, or rice, or salt. You can use paint of different colors. You could use all sorts of really fun craft supplies. Maybe ask your adults to help you find some stuff around the house. Let's start by planning your moon project. First, review the moon resource with an adult and learn a little bit more about the moon. You can get this sheet from your troop leader if you don't have it already. Then make a plan to go outside with an adult two different times of the day, one at daytime and one at night when it's dark out. I want you to observe the moon. It can be on the same day or a different day. And you're going to use two different pieces of paper to create two different art projects, one about the daytime sky and one about the nighttime sky. Remember what the moon looks like at both of these times so that you can create your art project. Okay, Girl Scouts, let's start our art project. So I have two pieces of paper, one for the nighttime sky and one for the daytime sky. We're going to start with tracing out our moon. So remember, what shape was our moon again? It's a circle. So we're going to use a bowl that's nice and big and round, and we're going to trace it on our paper. I'm going to do it on both pieces of paper, so that we have one for the daytime sky and one for the nighttime sky. There we go. So let's start with our daytime sky portrait first. We are going to think about what color the sky might be during the day. Is it dark or is it light? I think it's light, so let's get some paint to start with. What could we use to make... Oof. Okay, let's start with our nighttime sky. So what color is the sky at night? Is it light or is it dark? It's pretty dark, right? There's a lot of blue in it, a lot of black in it. You know, use your imagination and think about what colors you see. So I'm gonna start with a couple different techniques to make my white paper dark. Now you could always start with dark paper. You could do dark blue or dark black, but I didn't have any at home. So we're gonna be super creative. One technique that we can use is this tissue paper. I can take a little piece of tissue paper and I can rip it into tiny pieces. This is fun to do anyways. So I'm going to just rip it up into a bunch of small pieces. And I'm going to glue it on down. So I have some glue here. I'm going to spread it over paper. Okay, I'm going to spread this glue over the paper and I'm going to use it to stick this tissue paper to it. Now remember, we have our circle here in the middle. It might be hard to see, so we want to make sure that this part stays blank because we don't know how we're going to put our moon on yet. So I can use this. I can overlap the pieces. Doesn't that look neat? It's a pretty cool texture. If you feel it, it's kind of crinkly. It's kind of shiny, maybe a little bit, depending on what kind of tissue paper you have. So that's one technique you can use. What's another idea for making our white paper dark? I think I might use some paint. So think about what colors you see in the night sky. I see a lot of blue, a lot of purple, and you know, maybe some black too. So I'm gonna use a paintbrush and I'm going to use all of these colors and mix them together on my paper. So I'm just gonna put a big glob of this purpley blue color, big glob of this lighter blue color, and a little bit of black. And we're gonna just mix it all together. You see what color it makes? It's kind of like a swirly color. It looks pretty cool, doesn't it? I think that looks pretty good. I think I might put a little bit of purple in there too. It doesn't have to look perfect, right? But you can make it look however you want it to. But again, I have this big circle in the middle that I'm leaving blank because that's going to be our moon. Okay, can you think of any other ways to turn our paper dark? We might want to use some crowns to do that. So I have some crowns right here. Now, again, you can think about all the different colors. Maybe you want to start with a dark blue. Maybe you want to start with black. Maybe you want to start with purple. You can start however you want. So let's see what we got here. Ooh, I'm going to use some blue and some black to start. It's really fun. Sometimes you can hold the two crowns together like this. You can hold them both at the same time while you color. So you get scribbles of both colors on the paper at the same time. Maybe you want to add some more in. So maybe you want to put some purple and maybe a different color blue. Here's a really dark blue. Let's see what that'll look like. What do you think? Maybe you're going to have to tie these together. Maybe use a rubber band to get them to stick together. All sorts of cool ways to do this. You think you could do the same thing with markers or colored pencils? Definitely. So there, maybe once you have a few little scribbles down, you want to use some different colors. So here I have a lighter blue I'm going to use. What do you think? Does that look like pretty good night sky? I'm going to make sure it gets right up to the edge of my moon circle. So I have that ready. Okay, so now that we have our night sky mostly dark, should we add anything else to it? Should we add maybe some stars? I think we should add some stars. So let's think about some different ways to add stars. One cool way is actually to use rice. Because remember, what do stars look like in the night sky? Do they look like five-pointed stars like we're used to seeing? Not necessarily. So I'm going to use some rice. And these look like little white dots on my dark paint. And they just kind of stick already to the paint, which is nice. But if you want to put them on your crayons, or if you want to put them on your tissue paper, just use a few dots of blue. You can stick them down pretty well. Dots of blue. There we go. A few grains of rice. What else could we use to show stars? I have these really cool star stickers here. What color should we use? I normally think that stars in the night sky look silver, so I might use some silver stickers. But you can use what maybe you think they look gold, so you can use those. Whatever you want to use. I found this really neat hole puncher that I could use to punch out star shapes out of pieces of paper and then glue those down. Or I could use some white paint and paint those on. So I got a paintbrush here. I'm gonna put a little bit of white paint on it. And just kind of drop those on wherever I want a star. What do you think? Does that look pretty good? I think it looks good. So let's talk about our moon in the center. What color does it normally look like at night? I think it looks pretty white, but there's some gray spots and there's some black spots too. So let's start with some white. I'm going to use my paintbrush and some white paint. We'll do part of it with paint and we'll try another part with a different technique. It looks like there's already some black on my paintbrush, so it's looking a little gray. Now, when you looked at the moon, did you see a full moon? Was it completely lit up all the way around in a big circle? Or did you see just a portion of the moon, the crescent moon? If you saw a crescent moon, you might need to take part of your moon and actually paint it black. So I saw a little bit of a crescent moon. So I'm gonna paint part of this here black. Just do your best, however you think it looks best. Now, some people might have seen craters on your moon, especially if you're able to look through binoculars. So what could we use to make craters on our moon? We could use some paint. Maybe we could use some crowns for this one too. Let's bring those crowns back. I'm gonna use gray and black to make some craters. So what shape were those craters in? Were they mostly round? I think they're mostly round. Draw a mostly round circle. And some of them have little lines coming out from them like this, don't they? Especially if you have some really good close-up pictures of the moon, maybe off the internet or from NASA, you can see these lines coming off of a crater. And then it was maybe a little bit darker in the middle, so I'm going to use my black in the middle, but you can do it however you want. Make it some different craters. So that looks like a pretty good nighttime moon, doesn't it? Maybe I'm gonna make a few more craters. Let's talk about our daytime moon, okay? So if you remember seeing the moon during the day, what color was the sky around the moon? Again, was it dark or was it light? It's much lighter during the day. So let's pull out some different ways to make it light. We could maybe use some paint to start with. I'm gonna use some light blue paint. A little bit left in here, and you know that's a little too blue, so I'm gonna maybe put some white into it. If I mix it together, adding white paint to a color just usually makes it a little bit lighter, a little bit less bright, a little bit more. Look at that. Is that cool? Again, we have our big circle in the middle, so I want to put it up to there. How else could you make your daytime sky? Could you use crowns or markers? What color crowns do you think we should use? Let's see. I'm going to use some light blue, and actually I'm going to maybe put a little bit of yellow in it too. What in the sun do we normally see as yellow? What in the sky? What in the sky during the day do we normally see as yellow? I sometimes see the sun. Do some blue. I'm gonna do some yellow, and I kind of am gonna shade them together. Does that look like the sun in the sky? You can make it look however you would like. So once you have your daytime sky, maybe was there some clouds in your daytime sky? I'm gonna use these really cool cotton rounds, and I'm going to pull them into clouds. They might just stick straight onto your paint. Or you might need to put some glue down to stick them down, whichever you would prefer. What else did you see in the sky during the day? Were there birds? Were there different maybe an airplane in the sky? You can put all of that on your arm. So now let's look at our daytime moon. Was this moon was it a complete circle? Again, maybe not. So I would maybe start with a little bit of it made into a crescent, just like you might have seen outside. I'm gonna take this, I'm gonna just kind of paint a crescent. You could use a crown to draw a crescent if you prefer. Kind of running out of black tape. And maybe instead of seeing it black during the daytime sky, you just saw part of it that blended into the sky. So maybe you want to put a little bit of blue paint in that too, so it kind of blends into the sky. However you saw it is the way that you should make it. Now, the moon itself, did you see it as brightly during the daytime as we did at night? I'm not sure I did. I actually thought it looked a little fuzzy. So I'm going to use some of these cotton rounds, and I'm going to use them to make our moon. So let's put some glue down to start with. Okay, let's squeeze some glue onto our moon. Okay, so now let's take these cotton rounds and I'm going to stretch them out just like we did for our clouds and kind of put them down. Now, was the moon totally white or was it maybe kind of gray in the daytime sky? I think I saw a little bit of gray. You could do this with cotton balls too if you have those at home. Whatever you want. Gives a really cool texture to your moon, doesn't it? So I'm going to use a little bit of gray paint. If you don't have gray, you can just mix some black paint with white paint. And I'm going to kind of use that to paint in little gray spots throughout my moon. What do you think? Are those craters that we saw in the night? They might be. What do you think? Does that look like a good moon? Again, make your moon look however you would like. And be super creative with this project and have a lot of fun. And I hope you show us pictures of your moons when you're all done.
One thing that scientists do after they do something new is think about what they learned, what they liked or didn't like, and what they might want to do next. We're going to do this today too. What is one thing you learned today about the moon? Do you know what the word orbit means? What does the moon orbit around? Now, be a great scientist and share with your family some of the discoveries you made today. And that's it. You've completed one step of the Brownie Space Science Adventurer Badge. You've investigated and learned about the moon. If you or your Girl Scout like this activity, like this video and tell us in the comments below what you enjoyed. Be sure to subscribe to our channel and get other videos with fun Girl Scout activities to do at home. We'll see you next time.